Welcome to Mercenary Field here in Chirac, Illinois, home of the Midway Mutants.
Also home of the White Schlocks and the Flubs.
Also home of the most state politicians in jail hall of fame.
Both teams hit the field ready to hit each other in this MFL matchup. The Killadelphia Evils go up against the Midway Mutants. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest. The greatest, I tell you. Okay.
It's game day here on the MFL Network, and we are just about to get underway. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
Hi.
Any thoughts on today's game?
No, not really. Kind of flatlining right now in the thoughts department. Hey, can you help me get this pencil out of my ear? It's stuck worse than it was the last time.
Oh, you idiot. He's at the 10. And he recovers the fumble and runs it back for a defensive score. That's a backbreaker for the offense. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
You know, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They had the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected. Those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and 10. And that's some good old-fashioned downhill running as he picks up 9 yards on the play. And that'll bring up second and 1. Hey, kids, do you remember getting shoved in a locker because you wore glasses? I do. He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. And that'll bring up third and 1.
Hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and 10. He picks up 5 on that play. Second down and 5. Third down and 6. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And the punter has one job to do, and that's punt the ball. They let the punt drop, and it will be down by the defense. And it's first and 10. He rifled that one in there, and they come up with 10 yards on the play. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. And that's a first down. Looks like they're just going to pound it up the middle all night, Bricks.
They call that the honeymoon offense.
I'm not going to touch that one.
That's what she said.
And it's first and ten.
The way a Republican congressman hits the airport men's room. Good and hard. First down.
And it's first and ten. Nice run for 5 yards. Second down and five. Picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
Pow! With the brain scrambler!
That's not fair. Someone should call a penalty on this ref.
Death penalty. Hang them by the nuts.
Third down and long. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery.
Chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and ten. Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and ten. Down and, well, good luck. I guess when the coach said the offense was going to be explosive this week, he meant it literally. Down and never gonna happen. Oh, the receiver has to make that catch. Now he put the team in a hole. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
The return man catches the ball and hits. Oh, nice hit. And it's first and ten.
First down. He hit that line the way a rolled up dollar bill sticking out of flimsy Lohan's nose. It's a mare in Lost Wages, Nevada.
And it's first and ten. If you don't think you can make the interception, batting it down is the next best thing.
Great advice, Grim. That receiver's gonna go far.
It's anyone's game at the end of quarter one. Second down and ten. down. It appears that the ref just received a pair of very expensive alligator skin shoes. They need to put some cement shoes on before this game slips away.
I always wanted a pair of alligator skin shoes, Grim. I heard, though, when you put them on, they feel just like chicken skin shoes.
Second down, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. Second down in a mile. And they went to the air and came up big. Third down and three. Like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and 10. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Second down and six. He picks up a two. Third and four. When it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe two.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are freaks.
Good throw.
Yeah, if he was aiming for the ground.
Third down and five. And the quarterback throws a murder ball, which will slice. Oh, great throw! Great catch! And then puts 6 points on the board!
The defense could do anything to stop a throw that good, man!
You mean aside from bribing the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Punishing hit that one. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. The defensive players go berserk, and the defense gets the quarterback for a sack. Second down and more than the QB would like. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. Third down and the offense needs a miracle. The quarterback goes down. Zoom on his face. I want to see if he's crying. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life. He's not going down. Oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. And he picks up 10 on that run. Man, he nearly broke that one open, Bricks.
Yeah.
And so, that's the two-minute warning. Second down and inches. Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first timeout.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
Third down and 3. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
And it's first and 10. Stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Hey, man, you see that? That's right. You can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and 10. And he rumbles for 9 on that play. And he takes a timeout here. They have 2 left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just going to take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
Defenders are scared of this guy, Bricks, and they have every right to be.
Yeah, he's a murderer.
The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock blocked the clock.
And it's first and 10. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely.
And they take their last time out.
It's between them and the clock now, Grim.
Well, and the defense, too. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. And that's the kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick 6. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
The offense changes the pace by going into a hurry up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry up, too?
Grim, can I kill him?
First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. No receivers open, so the QB just threw the ball away. And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range.
Boring. Just get the points and let's move on.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and 10. Whenever a player gets big like this, reminds me that he might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in it.
It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsatan Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. It's anyone's game as the third quarter begins. Both teams have taken their performance-enhancing drugs, and everyone is ready to rock and roll. The teams line up for the second half kickoff. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. And it's first and 10. That's a 6-yard gain. Second down and 4. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, Graham.
And it's first and 10. Six. Touchdown! Touchdown! Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and 10. That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Second and 3. And it's first and 10. Good throw, good catch, but not quite good enough at 9 yards. And that'll bring up second and 1. And he breaks through for a touchdown. Listen to this crowd. If you don't kill this ref with the attack ref dirty trick, you're gonna lose, pal.
You kind of deserve it if you're this dense, Grim.
Yeah. Second down and long. And the offense jumps on sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. That's a big game run on that. Third down, and the punter is warming up. The defense better watch out. The quarterback just threw a murder ball.
I loved it.
Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown.
Yo, man, nobody can touch you when I take all your mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
And what about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and 10. Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? Deadline ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. Second down and 10. Third down and long. This is your brain, and this is... Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potato chips. As they say at the deli, who's next?
Can I get a Swiss on rye with no mustard?
Just one. Just get some butter on time.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. It for 4 yards. Second down and 6.
That was a nice piece of running, Grim. That's a first down.
And it's first and 10. Yard gain there. That's a solid pickup.
I wish people would do solid pickups more often. I step in dog turds on my front porch every day.
And that'll be second down and 4. Defense was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. Third and four. No, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Catch the ball, asshole.
Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt. They're going for a fake punt. That's riskier than sticking your hand in a blender and flipping a random switch.
Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too.
And it's first and ten. Quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and ten. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. And it's first and ten. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
With a brutal hit. Third down and eight. And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's first and ten. Not much there, maybe a yard. Second down and nine. And the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's first and ten.
Shocked is no joke. I used to wear triple wolf socks, slide around on a shag carpet for 8 hours so I could shock my younger brother. I went to change the TV channel, he got blown across the room into the deer antlers.
Second down and six. And that's the way you play a guy. Nice coverage. Third down and six. And he picks up four on that pass and catch. Man, these guys have metal balls. They're going to try to pick up the first down here.
Do they jingle when they run?
They clank, you moron. He said balls, not bells.
Oh, man, the offense called a murder ball. Put on a display there. Touchdown! And this ref is definitely on the take. That was a bogus penalty.
Yeah.
There's no reason to go. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Ballsy? Stupid, maybe? I guess we'll decide after we see how this goes. But probably stupid. He is fine. The defense wasn't ready for that at all, Bricks. The offense converts on fourth down and keeps the drive alive. And it's first and ten. One in for the first down. First down and one. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. And these guys think kicking is for pussies, Bricks. They're going for two.
Yeah, they got big balls, Grim.
Yeah, bigger than yours.
Bam! Gutsy run for the conversion. Man, those bones can boogie.
The lack of muscle, fat, organs, and skin really makes it easy for him to dance.
Home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five!
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse. Welcome to the Right Wage. How can I help you?
Take a double Roy burger, large Roy fries, and a big Roy gulp.
Anything else?
Yeah, I'm just gonna rip your head off and get out of here. That's about it.
His cleats are caked in blood and got fumble. You gotta protect the ball better than that. He could go all the... Yeah, never mind. First and ten. And he gets 3 yards on that run. Second down and seven. Defense holds him to a 4 yard pickup there. Third down and three. And that'll bring us to the 2 minute warning. It's do or die now. Third down and three. And it bombs away. The defense has to do a better job. The ref calls a penalty. You know, the MFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
Stupid jerks. You guys suck.
The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. QB needs to stop kissing his lineman and get back to the line of scrimmage. And it's first. Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. brings it in there for a 4-yard gain. Second down, and the quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and ten.
Yeah, timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Brett. You got to use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry-up.
Yeah, same as Britch's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and ten. Comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Looks like they're lined up for an onside kick. Stepped up and blew up. He's got a lot of guts, doesn't he? And you can see the ground crew cleaning him up now. Hot potato gets him every time. And it's first and ten. That run is good for 9 yards. The Midway Mutants lose the game. The home team comes up 2 points short and a real heartbreaker.
It was also a backbreaker, a knee breaker, and a neck breaker.
What, with the Quaker, the banker, and the candlestick maker? What are you, 3 years old, you fucking simp?
He's got a point, Bricks. Let's take it down to the MVP.
See that, boo, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see it.
Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Heart Corporation. They get it right every up.